July 6th, 2024. It's a quiet evening at Muan International Airport in South Korea. A Jeju Air flight approaches the runway after a routine trip from Bangkok. But as the plane descends, something goes horribly wrong. The landing gear fails, the plane skids, and within seconds, a fiery explosion engulfs the aircraft. Out of 181 passengers, only two survive. A father waiting at the airport that evening would never get to see his daughter again. She was one of the 179 lives lost in the fiery tragedy. Once an icon of innovation and trust, Boeing now finds itself embroiled in scandals, lawsuits, and devastating crashes. How did the aviation giant fall from grace? Over 100 years ago, Boeing emerged as a leader in aviation, known for groundbreaking engineering. From the early 707 jetliner that made international travel accessible, to the iconic 747 jumbo jet introduced in 1969, Boeing defined the golden age of commercial aviation. These planes connected continents and revolutionized air travel, solidifying Boeing's status as a pioneer in the industry. For decades, Boeing thrived on innovation. Engineers were given free rein to experiment and perfect designs. The company's aircraft became symbols of safety and reliability, trusted by airlines and passengers worldwide. But this golden age wouldn't last forever. In 1997, Boeing merged with McDonnell Douglas, a decision that many insiders now view as the beginning of its decline. The merger brought significant changes. McDonnell Douglas executives, known for their cost-cutting measures, gained influence in Boeing's leadership. Safety and innovation took a backseat as executives focused on maximizing shareholder value, setting the stage for a series of catastrophic failures. After the merger, Boeing shifted its production strategies. One of the most controversial decisions was outsourcing. Instead of manufacturing plane parts in-house, the company began contracting suppliers from around the world. While this saved costs, it introduced inconsistencies in quality. Reports emerged of poorly fitted components and unfitted wiring, leading to costly repairs and delays. The 737 MAX disaster became the ultimate symbol of these cost-cutting measures. Two crashes within 5 months, Lion Air Flight 610 and Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302, killed 346 people. Investigators found that a faulty software system called MCAS was to blame. Even more shocking, Boeing knew about the issue but chose not to ground the planes. Internal emails revealed a toxic corporate culture. One employee wrote, "This airplane is being designed by clowns, who in turn are supervised by monkeys." Leaked documents showed engineers repeatedly warning their superiors, only to be ignored or dismissed. The public's trust in Boeing's safety standards began to crumble. Several employees tried to sound the alarm as Boeing's troubles deepened. John Barnett, a former quality manager with over 30 years at Boeing, revealed shocking details about safety lapses in the production of the 787 Dreamliner. He reported that debris, such as tools and metal shavings, was left inside fuel tanks of new planes. Barnett also highlighted issues with oxygen systems in the Dreamliner, claiming a 25% failure rate in tests. Despite his concerns, Barnett faced retaliation and was dismissed. Tragically, Barnett's story ended in heartbreak. On March 9, 2024, he was found dead in his vehicle in Charleston, South Carolina, from a self-inflicted wound. His death occurred amidst an ongoing lawsuit against Boeing, raising questions about the company's treatment of whistleblowers and the immense pressure placed on those who spoke out. Another whistleblower, Joshua Dean, a former quality auditor at Spirit AeroSystems, a key Boeing supplier, also came forward. Dean exposed critical manufacturing defects in the 737 MAX program and highlighted leadership's refusal to address them. His sudden death from illness in April 2024 further fueled scrutiny of Boeing's culture and its ripple effects across its supply chain. These whistleblower sacrifices underscore systemic issues within Boeing's production processes. they revealed a corporate culture that prioritized cost-cutting over safety, leaving workers who raised alarms vulnerable and unsupported. The problems didn't stop with the 737 MAX. In December 2024, Boeing faced a series of incidents that further tarnished its reputation. On December 28, 2024, KLM Flight 1204 in Norway experienced a hydraulic failure that forced an emergency landing. While no lives were lost, the close call highlighted ongoing maintenance issues. The following day, December 29, Jeju Air Flight 2216 in South Korea suffered a bird strike that damaged the landing gear, leading to a fiery crash. Out of 181 people, only two survived. That same day, an Air Canada flight in Halifax encountered a landing gear malfunction, causing one wing to scrape the runway, creating sparks and panic among passengers. Miraculously, there were no injuries. Each incident raised questions about Boeing's quality control and engineering practices. How could a company that once symbolized safety allow such failures to happen? But these crashes were not isolated events. Behind them lay systemic issues, rushed production schedules, cost-cutting measures, and a corporate culture more focused on profits than passenger safety. Beyond high-profile crashes, Boeing has faced a litany of maintenance issues. Former employees have reported frequent use of temporary fixes on critical systems, with the expectation that permanent solutions would come later, but often, they never did. Examples include faulty sensors and outdated cockpit displays that pilots have complained about for years. These problems are exacerbated by a lack of standardized training for airline mechanics. While Boeing provides technical manuals, inconsistencies in how airlines address maintenance mean that planes may not always meet safety benchmarks. The result? A ticking time bomb for passengers and crews. At the heart of Boeing's production struggles is the immense pressure placed on workers. Employees have described grueling conditions, with overtime and unrealistic deadlines becoming the norm. Whistleblowers from Boeing's South Carolina plant alleged that managers often ignored safety concerns to meet production quotas. A chilling account from one worker revealed that unqualified temporary hires were assigned to assemble critical components. The worker stated, they would teach someone how to tighten bolts in the morning, and by afternoon, that person would be working on a plane set to fly the next day. While Boeing struggled, its biggest rival, Airbus, took a different approach. The European manufacturer focused on fostering collaboration between engineers and executives, ensuring that safety wasn't compromised for speed. Airbus's A320neo, which directly competes with Boeing 737 MAX, is known for its reliability and fuel efficiency, helping the company gain market share. Airbus also invested heavily in pilot training and customer support, building long-term trust with airlines. This contrast highlights how leadership priorities can drastically impact an aviation company's reputation. Boeing has promised to learn from its mistakes. The company announced a $2 billion investment to modernize its factories and improve safety protocols. New training programs aim to ensure that employees prioritize safety over deadlines. Additionally, Boeing pledged to redesign certain systems in its planes to eliminate risks like those seen in the 737 MAX crashes. One key initiative is a new safety council, designed to provide oversight and ensure that engineering decisions prioritize safety. Boeing also plans to debut a new, fuel-efficient plane in 2027, which it claims will be the safest model yet. The company has also implemented enhanced whistleblower protections to encourage employees to speak out without fear of retaliation. However, skepticism remains. Some insiders report that despite public promises, Boeing continues to cut corners to save costs. Lawsuits related to the 737 MAX and other incidents are still unresolved, further damaging the company's reputation. Meanwhile, Airbus continues to solidify its position as the industry leader. The question remains, can Boeing truly recover? Trust, once lost, is incredibly hard to regain. The company's story serves as a stark reminder of what happens when safety takes a backseat to profits. The next time you board a plane, will you trust the name Boeing, or has the cost of their mistakes been too high for redemption? Let us know your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more in-depth stories like this.